So have you ever wondered how your vaporizer actually works? Well, it's really fascinating. In this video, you're going to be taken behind the scenes and introduced to the science of vaping. First, we have to look at the simple notion of heating, and that is conduction versus convection. These are the two main ways a vaporizer will heat your oils and dry herbs. You would have been taught this in high school, but for some of us, that was a long time ago, right? So let's recap. Firstly, what is the difference between the two? Conduction transfers the heat of energy through direct contact, just like a kettle on a hot stove. Convection is the movement of hot air in and around the desired materials. Think of how your blow dryer works. Now, different vaporizers use different methods, so it's worth knowing which does what and what you prefer. So let's now look at the pros and cons of convection and conduction. Since conduction was the first method used in vapes, they are generally inexpensive compared to the counterparts and usually heat up faster. However, the vast consensus is conduction vaporizers are less efficient. This is because any material heated through conduction will be unevenly vaped. It requires you to stir or shake in between draws to reduce the risk of combustion. Convection is a better option. The only cons with convection heating devices is the initial expense and the slightly slower heating ability. But the pros do outweigh the cons. With amazing features like more accurate temperature control, even heating of the materials, which is your dry herbs or oils, and a much lower risk of combustion. So when shopping for a conduction vaporizer, here are the three main signs to look out for. They generally have a battery-powered heating chamber or an open-flame heating plate or a Bunsen-powered heating chamber. If you're after a convection vape, you need to look out for these features. Firstly, an internal fan or forced air fan, a fan assist function, or convection-specific screens for a chamber. Now, before wrapping up, I wanted to answer some common vaping questions. Firstly, what happens when I draw? Is the inhale different to smoking? Vaporizing is different to smoking a cigarette. When vaping, it's important to take longer and slower draws or inhales. And while some users inhale to the lungs, others find the effects work simply by holding the vapor in their mouth for a few minutes. This is very similar to the way one smokes a cigar. Really, the draw or inhale is all about your personal preference. Some manufacturers may even offer suggestions or guides on how best to vape with their devices. Next, so how does your body consume the vapor so you feel its effects? Vapor is actually a form of gas, thus it causes a reaction instantly. The body's ability to use this vapor works faster because the lungs inhale it and then it's in your bloodstream right away. Many people actually use herbs this way for natural, medicinal or therapeutic reasons. What you're inhaling is the vapor of the essential oil or herb, so there is no digestive work that goes into inhaling vapor. Which brings us to, does vaporizing actually smell? Vaporizing is barely noticeable compared to other traditional methods like smoking. Usually a window open will completely rid your area of the smell within a few minutes. However, with a good quality device and if you're using it properly, you should barely notice any smell at all. And finally, does vaporizing cause smoke? The actual burning of the material, whether it's oils or dry herbs, is usually contained in some sort of glass bubble or inner chamber. Some large devices actually accumulate the vapor in a bag or in whips and you inhale it from them. Once you've inhaled or taken your draw, the amount of vapor expelled from your mouth is very minimal, and this dissipates within a few seconds to minutes. And that's it for your science lesson today on vaping. We hope that you are now more informed about the science of vaporizing and ready to go.